Is Notion good for project management? Notion is an amazing all-in-one tool, but it's important to understand the pros and cons so that you can determine if it's the right tool for specific project management needs. This video will be covering the top features that sets Notion apart, as well as some of the cons that you might want to know about before choosing to use Notion for project management. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first feature that sets Notion apart from other project and task management tools is that it is very flexible. So the flexibility is a major advantage with using Notion because you can basically structure your pages however you see fit for your specific company needs and situations. So for example, in our ultimate project and task manager here, you can see that the layout is with the projects here and the current sprint and tasks below, but you could also interchange these or add other sections that are relevant to specific needs in that particular project management. So for example, if we open one of the projects up, you can also see that you can basically add any kinds of properties that you want. You can add specific formulas that calculate things that are specific to your particular niche or project and so on. So the flexibility that Notion has is really unmatched. And the other element is that if you do use Notion for project and task management, you can also have your habit tracking, personal planners, and all of these things all in one space. So it can go from anything from meal planning all the way to complex project and task management, which makes it a really great all-in-one tool. The other thing to consider when deciding whether or not to use Notion is its generous pricing plan. So this is especially relevant if you are a small business and you're trying to just set things up, start using Notion as a project management tool, then you'll likely be able to start pretty much for free. And the only limitations are that you can only invite 10 guests. Each guest are free, so they can collaborate with you on that page. So if that page is the project and task management template, you can basically have up to 10 collaborators there without having to pay $10 a month for each seat. The only downsides is that, of course, with the Plus plan, you do have unlimited file uploads and things like that. But if you're really using it as a light project management tool, you'll likely be able to start for free, which makes Notion a great tool if you want to start small and then gradually scale your business. The next aspect of Notion that's really amazing for project and task management is its automation capabilities. Basically, if we have our ultimate project and task manager here, and you have a Plus plan, or you download a template that has these automations built in, you can add new automations by going to this lightning bolt mark, and you can add triggers, things like if the status changes, you can actually set a different person to be assigned. You can also send notifications. So let's say that if the status changes to paused, you want to send a specific notification. You can do something like this, add an action. You can send Slack notifications to a certain channel. You can send notifications to a certain person and so on. So this kind of automation makes it very useful for project and task management. You can also automate setting up the dates. For example, if something is completed, you could set a completed date to a certain date automatically. So there is also a lot of flexibility with the automations. And the automations also include using buttons as automations. So if you wanted to go that route, there are also a lot of things you can do with Notion's buttons to automate tasks. The other relatively new feature that came out with Notion that also makes it even better as a project management tool is the Notion charts. And this is only available to Plus plan members. If you're on the free plan, you still get one free chart. So you can still see a very useful diagram of what's going on with your project, for example, with time distribution and so on. So as you can see here, you can see the estimated hours versus actual hours. You can see future and current sprint tasks. You can see daily task completions. And all of these things can be set up to be highly customized. So you can choose exactly what kind of visuals you want to see for your project and task management needs. And then the final pro for using Notion as your project and task manager is just the amount of database views that are available. So if we go to our projects here and then we go to the three dots here and then layout, you can see that you can basically view any of your data sets in a table, board, timeline, calendar, list, gallery, or chart. And this makes it very flexible so that it really depends on your style of working and how you want to see things. So in this case, planning is here and progress is here and you can drag them around. But if you prefer a board view, you can also see them this way as well. So there's really a lot of ways to work and use these kinds of views. And some other project and task management tools might have paywalls that block certain views and things like that. But with Notion, basically everything like that is available. The only limitation is with the charts if you're on the free plan, but otherwise you can see all of your information in different views. Now let's get into some of the cons for using Notion as project and task management tool. So as you can see, this template is quite complicated for project and task management. It does have some learning curve in terms of how to use Notion and how it works. So if you're trying to set something up from complete scratch, it could take quite a lot of time to actually learn Notion, to learn what the needs are, and then not get too overwhelmed by all the features available. So in that sense, the cons for using Notion can be sometimes the complexity and learning curve, and then kind of taking away from the time that you want to spend already managing your projects. The time might be going to setting up the system. But once you do have the system, it can work really well and be very customized and personalized for your needs. The next downside is the recurring tasks feature in Notion. It's called recurring database templates, but it can be used as a system to set up recurring tasks or recurring meetings or anything recurring inside of that database. So the downside for this, if we go ahead and click the three dots for each new task, if we wanted to repeat this task, you'll notice that you can repeat it daily, weekly, monthly, yearly, and this is very similar for other task management tools. However, you don't get to see the task in advance, so it's going to show up on the day that it repeats. It also doesn't track whether or not you completed it, so you could have multiple duplicates if you don't complete any of your tasks, and they could just keep piling up. So in that sense, the recurring feature has some limitations if you're looking for what a traditional recurring task system would do for you. So the next thing is that Notion doesn't have any built-in reporting features. If you need to create reports and things like that, you will have to sort of create your own reports using the available databases and figure out what kind of reports you want. So there's no simple reporting system in Notion. So that can be sort of a difference between other project and task management tools. You can export your pages by going to the three dots on the right hand side and then going to export if you want to export what's here to show other people. But overall, it can be kind of limiting. Another issue with Notion, if you plan to have hundreds and thousands of tasks and a huge number of projects, is that it can get quite laggy the more tasks and projects that you input here. And many people have talked about how it can be a bit slow sometimes. So that's another thing to consider with Notion if you are planning to have a really large number of information. However, if it's a small team or small project, you might not notice anything in terms of the speed. So this is kind of up to how it feels to use Notion. Finally, this is only applicable if you want to use a sprint feature in your project and task management. But with Notion, the sprint feature has to be either built in customized like this, where you have all of these built in to Notion databases, or you can use Notion projects. However, with Notion projects, you can't really edit the base template, which makes it a little bit hard to use sometimes. So just keep in mind that there is limited customizability if you use Notion projects for your project management, as opposed to if you use a custom template like this. Overall, Notion is a solid project and task management tool if you're able to spend time to learn and set things up. The flexibility and all-in-one features and the ability to essentially create your own tool is groundbreaking. However, if you're looking for a quick pre-made solution or something easy to use, there might be other tools that could fit your project management needs. I hope that this gave some overview on the pros and cons of using Notion for project and task management. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to drop them below. Check out the link in the description if you're looking for the ultimate project and task management Notion template. Thanks for watching and hope to see you all in the next video.